Firstly, I want to take some philosophical perception because knowledge is so important issue for philosopher and thinker. In the early times to our new modern times, many people ask some question about knowledge. What is knowledge? What is research of knowledge? Early Greek philosophers. The debates about possibility, search, limits, and criteria of knowledge. We can call them rationalists. For rationalist knowledge, search of knowledge or thinking and reasons. But empiricalist search of our knowledge, observation and experiments about our words. But for Marx, search of our knowledge come from our activities. We are create our knowledge and knowledge come for our daily activities. In contrast to Marx, Engels described the search of knowledge as a human. In contrast to Engels, research of our knowledge is come from our outside. Knowledge is endless. We can knowledge everywhere and every times. But every people's know that it's important word knowledge is power. Francis Bacon, he's England's philosopher, he take many important words knowledge is power. Actually, is so we can understand these words misunderstands because any knowledge is not power. It's just about methods. Nib Organum, it's a book of Francis Bacon. It's merely early modern times perceptions. He's a philosopher, philosophic, and it's Nib Organum against Aristotelian's philosophy and the ideals of the mind. Is a nation of the progressive accretion of knowledge of the natural world obtains thought, close observation acts and experiments and refined and banded by successful science. Knowledge is power, but it's just a suggestion about methods. Because for Bacon, you can some tools and you can create some materials. If you want to create some materials, you have to use some tools. For these, for science, you can use also some tools like a reason. Knowledge, it will be all reason. If we want to take as some correct reason, correct subject, we have to use methods for science. Knowledge is power. Refer to these mentality and. We can go developments and different perception about knowledge also too. I want to talk about middle age knowledge perceptions. Maybe we can look for these name of the rose. Many important books. Umberto Eco, he's Italian writer. He have a good novel, Name of the Rose. It's about medieval age relationship between knowledge and power. His focus on church. In the church, you cannot reach the books because some people just read and describe these books. In these times, knowledge is mysteries because not everyone connect the knowledge. Just some elite people like church society can connect this word, connect the books. Power of knowledge come from her mystery in these times. We can scholastic time, it is also these times. After this process, in modern times, for 19th century, we can see that perception of knowledge, it will be changed. Knowledge will be used for everything, and after after Martin Luther King's, we can see knowledge shared everywhere in the world. Many people can read some books and they know about other people's governments and kingdom. It is times for we can describe these times of transparency. Early 19th century, we can see that knowledge is so aggressively shared, so aggressively. For example, during the World War II, Joseph Goebbels, his information ministry of Nazi German. Mentality of Joseph Goebbels, you have to share your knowledge everywhere and every times because all peoples need to simple words. We can describe the her perception is propaganda. He is a father of propaganda. In this time, knowledge is everywhere and knowledge, you can take a knowledge, it's an order and you should get it. Mentality of Joseph Goebbels. It's time for perception is knowledge. For this time, we can see that it's different. Maybe we can talk about Michel Foucault. He is a so important scholar, French scholar. He take anatomy, knowledge, and power. Foucault focus on some important debates about knowledge, punishment, order, and power. For Foucault, power is everywhere and every times. It's not just about governmental or ruling power. You can see power everywhere. For example, relationship between father and children, or between boss and staff. Because power is everywhere and it's every time can be changed. For Foucault, power is not a bad things. It's the normal things. Because power come from our human beings or human nature, and he have many important methods. He can describe these methods archaeology. For Foucault, archaeology method is a new method for social science. You can follow up the story of, for example, for historical events. Historical events not just about war. It's about also history of some things, some idea, some historical of buildings or anything. And for knowledge for and what is knowledge for Foucault? Actually, knowledge he take some episteme for knowledge for according to Foucault, we have three times episteme. It's first, it's there is last time episteme is the modern time episteme. It's knowledge is not like a thinking that you can this describe. Knowledge is outside of our idea and our perspective for Foucault. And knowledge can knowledge and power relation is mutual relations. Knowledge affect the power, and power is also affect the knowledge for the Foucault. They need to themselves. They need to themselves, and Foucault have some important relation, important idea about. Power is also for Foucault. Our modern word power is bio power, and it's power you can power everywhere. For example, and every times it's not instance times. In the instance times, power just have to outside of our home, but no power everywhere. And you can see everywhere. It's like a bio power. Maybe you know that panopticon systems. It is many important England scholar. He take a new systems for punishments. It's a buildings and articulated systems. With this system, you can see all. Punishments without the you can without you despair. For Foucault, this is we can adaptate this system in the social life and economic life and governmental life. In this modern world. Governmental systems like these, it's not a pair, but it's really it's show see you is and Foucault take a new anatomy about knowledge, relationship, knowledge and power. It is just philosophical perception, but in our new words, is our new digital words, everything has been changing, and it will be changing also. Maybe we can look our new words, new digital words. In these times, we have a new phase about. Face of knowledge. Maybe we can ask some question: who is protecting knowledge, and who is disrupting knowledge? Who holds the knowledge and knowledge, information, and science? Differences between about knowledge, information, and science. Knowledge, if you want to look at the historical times, maybe it is, we can see that who is protecting knowledge, because university and some, one of the best protecting institution, it's university, high school and secondary school, family and some private institution or social life and treatments protecting knowledge, but no, it's so mixed. Who is protecting knowledge? University is also now protecting knowledge, and family and school normal education systems, formal education systems protecting knowledge, but it's some new institution is also protecting knowledge. If you look at the sharing of the knowledge, we can see that internet is one of the best institution protector for knowledge. And who is distracting knowledge? In the cold during the Cold War and early 19th century, United States and Europe is one of the best protector and distributing. During the 15 years, our world is European setting. After 15 after 15 years, Europe's protecting knowledge and distributing knowledge. It's word the science of words based on European and United States perceptions. It's these times many people go to Europe or United States take a knowledge and education because they are a development country. But it's our new world, our new digital world, protecting and distributing of knowledge has been changing because of digital instruments and digital advances. With the internet, is world connected together. It, we have a digital world, and sharing and protecting knowledge is so easy. And but these times is also based on European centric, Western centric, excuse me, Western centric. Industrial times, as science and knowledge holding by European country. For example, car, fly, or train industry take by European country, but our new world, it's digital times, firstly based on the United States because internet innovated by the United States and central of device building in United States. But after millennium times, some Eastern country like China, Japan, South Korea, and Russia also new now, take some important advantages about internet and digital worlds. We can describe these times as globalization of knowledge. Knowledge is globalizing things. Every people go take a knowledge. For example, United States, they have new policy, new knowledge policy, open access policy. You can access one of the best university in the world, library open with the internet, because they mentality we can and we have to share our knowledge and our science all of the world. But China, it's debate this perception because he believed that if you are globalization of knowledge carry out by the England English language and they try to take themselves internet systems and online systems, but it's not so successfully attending successfully activities. Many people know Alan Turing. He's a modern times scientist. He's maybe we can call him father of modern early digital world. Dream of Alan Turing, the founder of computer science and other information utopians, did not come true. The web is developing the world, but this electronics is opening it up rather than bridging the gap between the poor and rich, because of new or worlds, some country and some society have some problem with access of internet. They suffer from lack of internet access. It's or new world order is also not equal, and sharing of knowledge and connecting knowledge is not equal or worse, because some developing country holding all systems, technological systems and knowledge systems. For example, some North European country like Norway, Sweden, Norway, Denmark, access of internet highly decrease. It's but for African countries not possible. They lack of the access of internet, and but we can say that our new world is not like ancient times or medieval times or early 20 times. You can see some maps. It's look, there have some maps about production of knowledge, and we can see that production of knowledge is main productor of knowledge is the United States, North America and European Unions. We can see that some Japan, China and India is also have protection, new knowledge protector. Maybe we can talk about new phase of and new form of production of knowledge, artificial intelligence and machine learning. There is a new form for production of knowledge. For example, if you look at who is production of artificial intelligence, we can see that China is one best protector. China ranks the first publication on artificial intelligence. United States come to second, and Europe, the European countries come after American United States. In this, like for European after European Union, is Russia, India, Turkey, and Iran come the other important publication about the artificial intelligence. Knowledge product by machine and artificial intelligence, not product by human. It's so important and different times for production of knowledge, because in the early times, just people can protect knowledge, and but now machine will be protect knowledge is sentimental with the sentimental artificial intelligence and machine learnings. Machine and artificial intelligence will be examine and describe about knowledge. They will thinking for ours, for humanity. It's a new and really different times. maybe scholarships and scientists will be describe ethics of knowledge and new perception of knowledge. In conclusion, what we can say? I think it's we don't have a is conclusion because it's so highly interesting debate. It will be debating too, because knowledge will be protecting and face of knowledge will be changing also. But we can maybe we can talk some important point for this issue, relationship between knowledge and power. Information protecting institution have changed. The influence of traditional knowledge protecting institution in knowledge protection has described. With the digitalization, information dissemination, dissemination and protecting have accelerated. Also, it's difficult to talk about knowledge hegemony today. Information distribution is not fair because some important country tech its information on hold. They hold. Artificial intelligence and machine learning are at the forefront as new form of knowledge production. Machine setting generation of information is more common. Machines have almost turned into scientists. Maybe we'll see robotics teachers, robotics doctors and professor. Maybe we'll not go school or hospital for teaching and examination. Maybe it will be utopia or dystopia during the COVID times. We can see that is everything is based on online systems, and our new world order has been changed by COVID coronavirus periods. Knowledge and power balance still exists because who holds it or always or knowledge ahead, we don't know. We can say that is they have a relationship between knowledge and power. But it's just change, face of knowledge change also, and face of power is also changing. We cannot common discretion about power and also about knowledge, because you know, information is also sometimes can use for knowledge. Information have a different sense between knowledge and power is or new world debates. Some people say that knowledge is more specific information, but you can see information everywhere. It's not specific it's not specific information. Maybe we can say that is a new world. Everything has changing about power and knowledge during early times and our new world. Power changing is also knowledge changing. We will see new perception about this issue, because by the digital age and machine learning, I think so. Thank you so much for your listening and
thank you.